Alright guys, what is going on? Welcome to the Q&A, which I was meant to do about 2 weeks ago, but I fucking didn't. Now this Q&A might not be like the other Q&As I've done in the past. I've literally got my phone here, I'm gonna read. Actually, it will be pretty similar actually, I don't know what I'm talking about. The difference is I haven't got notes this time, so I haven't got answers pre-made. I'm literally gonna look at these comments now and answer them on the spot, alright guys? So there's no thinking about this, so it could be dodgy. However, we're still gonna read them out guys, every single comment. We have 29 comments, one of them was mine, so we have 28 comments to read through. Let's begin. Our first question is from Mr. Shady Shade. My question, how long, let's hold it here. My question, how long do you spend making a video, recording and editing time? Give me a shout out, please. Cheers. Well, okay. Give me a shout out, please. Well, you've pretty much just gave it to yourself there, mate. My question, how long do you spend making a video, recording and editing time? Depends on the video, really. A podcast often takes about an hour. Editing, it's just got to sync up a podcast, and then rendering a podcast takes hours, like 5 hours sometimes, something like that. A normal video like this, or like a gaming video, recording 30 minutes maybe at most. Editing probably takes about, it depends on the video really. If I'm just doing like a Rocket League video with no cuts or anything, editing could be as little as 30 minutes long. If I'm doing a video like my I Quit video, that takes hours. Which is the one where I like play chess in Minecraft, it's a jokey kind of video. So that's that, my answer to that really. Different videos take different amounts of time depending on how much effort I want to put into the video and what video requires what sort of effort, etc. Second question from the Welshman22. He's been with me quite a while, so cheers lad. That is fantastic news. I'm really happy for you. In fact, my channel is not doing too bad. So that wasn't really a question, to be honest, Welshman, mate, but thank you very much for your kind words. And I'm glad your channel's not doing too bad either, guys. Go check him out. And our third question is from Joe Mads. What would you rather, 1 million subs or £500,000? Fuck. 1 million subs, I think. Yeah, probably 1 million subs, because that, what, one, if you have 1 million subs, pretty much YouTube's your job there, so you're making a steady income, I'm guessing. Depends on how much, like, how many viewers can actually come back and watch all your videos. You could have 1 million subs but have no people watching your videos because they're shit. Sort of, you know what I mean. I'd rather go for the 1 million subs because I'd rather make YouTube my job, have a job that I love, instead of have £500,000, which I'll probably blow very quickly. Andy123sign is the fourth question. He says, Q&A question. In your opinion, what is the best and worst things about YouTube? And congratulations on 150 subs, bro. Thank you very much, Andy, you fucking legend. In your opinion, what's the best and worst things about YouTube? The best things about YouTube is the fact that it's a platform for people to create content they want. And just have freedom to create, to be creative, really, because creative people, everyone's creative in a sense, but people who want to be creative and share with the world can on YouTube, and it's a really good platform to build a community and have a fucking brilliant time, and stuff like that. And the best thing about YouTube is it's just like, it's better than TV. It's like TV, but so much fucking better. You can actually interact with the people you watch, etc. The worst things about YouTube? Fucking, I need the time to think about that one. The comment sections in some big YouTubers' channels, they're so like AIDS-y, mate. They're so like, oh, fuck. First, let me think of a joke, or Max Cazell, the type of person too, or something like that. Stupid shit, spammy comments, self-promoters on different people's channels, that's fucking annoying. That's it really, I can't really think of anything else bad about YouTube. Copyright's a cunt. Copyright's a big cunt, actually, especially when you're a big YouTuber and you're actually monetizing. I don't monetize my videos, which means that I don't try and make money for my videos. One, because it's pointless at my size, and two, that means it will just give you guys adverts for no reason. Why would I want to do that to you guys? So it's no point in me monetizing my videos at the moment. Yeah, copyright, when people monetize their videos and they get copyrighted and they take all their money from them, that's a fucking dick move, and copyright needs to be sorted out, if I'm gonna be honest. But I don't experience that at the moment. That's just something that I've seen people get angry about from YouTube. Next question is from LS Media. Well, and he's the person who I did that football challenge with ages ago, if you guys remember. Well deserved. Okay, here's the question. If you weren't supporting the Gunners, who would you support and why? It'd be Bournemouth, to be honest, because Bournemouth is like my hometown pretty much. I mean, I live like a couple minutes away from Bournemouth, so it's not really my hometown. Poole would be, but Poole Town are in a shitty league. And Bournemouth are actually in the Premier League now. And they were in the Championship. And they were in like a League 2 not too long ago, I think, something like that. So yeah, it'd be Bournemouth. And I was going to stop supporting Arsenal and support Bournemouth, but I love Arsenal too much, guys. I can't be ditching Arsenal. So yeah, it'd be Bournemouth. And that's why, because it's pretty much my hometown. Oh my god, we got a big fucking comment from Dude's Plays, as always, with the novels, lad. So his comment is this. This channel is almost a year old. What the fuck? Where is my life going? Mate, I was thinking that as well. Like, this is crazy. This channel is literally a year old. And before that, even Gazelius was even longer. Damn, mate. Anyway, my question is, when the hell are we going to do a video together? I swear down, we've been talking about it since Christmas and never got round to it. And maybe talking about it on a video will make us get our feet and our asses. Get us our feet out of our asses, never heard of that one before, and do a sick collab. Okay, we have actually done a collab by the recording of this video. We did a podcast. I'm trying to render it, but it's not rendering at the moment. It's being a Sony Vegas, my editing software, is being a dick. And it's not rendering the video. It keeps crashing. So when I find out a way to render that, I'll upload the podcast. It's actually podcast number 10. And the reason I haven't made a podcast is because I want me and Doozoo's podcast to be number 10. Because Doozoo's has been with me, I should call him Drew. Drew's been with me for very fucking long, like since the beginning, pretty much since the beginning when... It's a long story. It's not really that long, but I can't be asked to go into it. He knows it. I know it. All that matters. So yeah, we've done the video. We will do more videos together, definitely. You know, just talk on Skype to Drew and we'll get fucking videos done, mate. Also, overall thoughts on the Premier League this season. Arsenal finished second, which I was very happy about, but I was more happy about the fact they finished over Tottenham, who were pretty much destined to finish above us. I don't know how they didn't. Well, it's because they fucked up against Newcastle. And we beat, who was it that we beat? We beat Aston Villa, which put us over Tottenham. We came second. We didn't come first. Leicester came first. But you know what? I'm fucking happy for Leicester. A team that were in the relegation zone last season and now they're first this season and won the title. That will go down in football history, and I think it's fucking incredible. Rest of the comment, congrats on 150 subs, by the way. So deserving of it. 100% gonna go far beyond 1,000 subs one day. I remember how you were kind of worried about leaving behind your success on Gazelius to pursue this channel, and I like how almost exactly a year on, you're about to overtake Gazelius in terms of subs. Something about that settles some sort of OCD inside me. Cheers, man. I really appreciate that. Like, that fucking, that's made my day, mate. Thank you so much. Next question is from Illuminati Confirmed. Can you lick your elbow? Try it for the band. I did this a lot. I swear I've done this on like every single Q&A. I can't lick my fucking elbow. I can't, mate. Flexibility wise, I have no flexibility like that. That's the best I'm gonna fucking get you, Kevin. No, I can't fucking make that. That's not my mic as well. Maybe if I do it from this side, I'll try and like smack. If I break my fucking arm, I could probably do it. I look like a dick. I can't do it. I can't fucking do it. I'm sorry. Next question. Joe Manns, would you ever do how I edit my videos video? Yes, I would do that. I'd love to do that. So that'll be coming very soon. Not very soon, no. It'll be coming at some point. Next question is from Clay Dog. Kazelux, do you play mobile games such as Clash of Clans or World of Tanks Blitz? World of Tanks is on the PC as well. You should check it out. I just got something adapter sort of thing where I can connect to my Elgato and I can play mobile games. So I will be doing that more often, don't you worry. And I'll try out those games. Clash of Clans, I used to be addicted to Clash of Clans, but I probably won't play that because it's more of a game where you have to like play it a lot. And I don't think you guys would really like it. And I don't think I could get back into it. I spent so much time on it. I don't think I can get back into it. World of Tanks, never heard of it, but I can try that out, mate, definitely. Next question is from Jamie Gorgon. What kind of music are you into? If the answer is dance, then check my channel. Just kidding, but yeah, what music? Jamie's actually someone I go to college with. He's a good lad. What kind of music have I been into? I actually do like dance music. I really do like dance music a lot, actually. So yeah, I'll definitely check out your channel. Guys, go check out Jamie's channel. I'll leave a link in the description if I remember. I probably won't remember, but if the link is in the description, you can go there. Or you just type in Jamie Gorgon into YouTube. It's not really hard. Why do people put links in descriptions when you just type their name in? Fuck. But I'm mostly into hip-hop, rap and stuff like that, dance, can't really think of anything else. I like a bit of everything. I like rock, I like some pop music actually, anything really. I listen to really anything. The only thing I wouldn't really listen to is like classical, and like dubstep, except for Seven Nation Army remix, the White Stripes remix. That is a sick dubstep song. Apart from that, yeah, pretty much those music, those genres that I just listed. Next question is from Slicky T Dog. Shit 2,000 gallons of mayonnaise or shit one shuriken? That's disgusting. I'm thinking about the mayonnaise. I want to feel so. Oh, mate. Come on, man up. Man the fuck up, mate. Oh. That made me almost gag then, just thinking about that. But yeah, I mean the mayonnaise, because I don't want to shit a shuriken. It'll probably fucking kill me. Angel Buck with the next question. Would you rather spend £1,000 on food or £1,000 on clothes? For the bants, I want to say food, but obviously clothes. But yeah, £1,000 on food would be carnage, but I'd probably be a fat fuck. Even fucking fatter if I did that, so no. Next question. The Land of Octopuses. It feels like only a few months. Congrats on 150. Question. Oh, and by the way, thanks a lot, man. Really appreciate that. Question. Who are your top three favorite YouTubers of different genres? Holy fuck, I need to think about this. My top favorite YouTuber is probably The Smith Plays. He's probably my biggest inspiration ever. And his podcast I absolutely love. The Joe Rogan Experience, Joe Rogan's YouTube channel. I love his podcast so much as well. They're fucking brilliant. Who else do I watch? Like, a lot. I really need to hit my subscription list to find this out, lads. Yeah, guys, I'm looking through it now, and I think it's just gonna have to be Kazelux. He's just so fucking decent. He's the top fucking lad. He is a lad, when you think about it. Go check him out, guys. Go check out. This isn't even funny. It's not even a funny joke. Why am I making this joke? It's not. You're probably sitting there cringing. I'm cringing. Ugh. Yeah, guys, like I said, those are my favorite YouTubers. The Smith Plays, Joe Rogan, and that. And you know what? The Big Les Show official. The Big Les Show, mate. He's my favorite fucking YouTuber out of all fucking. Oh, mate, the Big Les. Next question is from the real Niglet, who is my friend Jibbit. Jib Jib. Can you dab, then do the whip and the nay nay? I can dab. Do a little dab. You get your arm up like that, don't you? And you go. Yeah, that was the dab. The nay nay, I think, is like. Is that the nay nay? Or is that. I don't know. I don't know the whip. Is it. Was that the nay nay? Moving on. Next question is from Mr. Your Red Guy. Oh my god, four questions. Oh fuck, okay. What's your favourite player for Liverpool? Sturridge, probably. Can I think of anyone else? Sturridge. Oh, Coutinho. He's fucking incredible, man. I love watching him. Two, do you fart a lot? Just as much as the average human being. Number three, have you got any siblings? No, I don't. I'm an only child. Four, tell me how to get big. I don't really know because I've only got 150 something subscribers, but you just gotta make consistent, which is fucking rich coming from me. Consistent, good quality content. Thumbnails are really important. I'm trying to improve my thumbnail game. Titles are important. Look up videos, guys, on how to, like, you know, do good on YouTube. It's really about consistency and making your videos to the tier of big YouTubers' videos, because some people, they make videos, but their thumbnails are shit, their titles are shit, they're not interesting. Not that they're not interested, but they don't come across interesting or entertaining. And you're just like, you're not really going to grow. You've really got to put a lot of work and passion into YouTube to really try and grow. I don't have any basis to say this on because I'm not big at all in the eyes of big YouTubers. But I feel like I know kind of how to at least grow a bit. I probably don't, but that's what my advice would be. Next question is from Owen Griffiths. What is your main goals for YouTube in the future? To make YouTube a job would be fucking amazing, because that means I could dedicate all my time to YouTube, and it's my favorite thing to do, like create fucking videos and just be creative and entertain people and build a community. It's like, if that could be my job and I don't have to have another job or anything else, I could just solely focus on this. That would be fucking amazing, guys. So that's probably my main goal. But my main goal is just to grow the community, and just carry on making entertaining videos and carry on making people laugh. Honestly, and that's literally it, guys. Next question is from Daniel Torley. Congratulations, you deserve it. Your vids have made my day. And my question is, why did you start YouTube in the first place? And how have you grown this big? Okay, so let's take this comment bit by bit, shall we? Congratulations, you deserve it. Thank you so much, man. I really appreciate that. And you've been with me for fucking ages now. You're a legend. Your vids have made my day. Thank you so much, man. I also really appreciate that. And my question is, why did you start YouTube in the first place, and how have you grown this big? I haven't grown this big. Like, this big, 150 subs, it's taken me a year. In the eyes of most people, that's not very good. Like, a year to get to 150 subs. But in my eyes, I think I've done quite well at the moment. When you take in consideration my inconsistency as well, there are times where I'd go weeks or maybe like a month or something without uploading videos, and it's bad. So I don't even deserve this many subs, to be honest, due to my inconsistency. Why did you start YouTube in the first place? Like I said, I love to entertain people. I had a look at like different YouTubers, and Far From Film as well was a massive inspiration for me, because I saw him, someone that does YouTube, and you're seeing like, wow, he's got like 13, well, at the time he had like 11,000. Subscribers or something like that, or 12,000. I was like, man, like, that must be so sick to have a community, people who watch you, to entertain people, everything like that. Oh, it just looks so awesome. And I just thought, fuck it, I'll give it a go. And I've been doing YouTube, like, years ago. I had little channels that were shit, and I'll do YouTube videos. I'll make like shitty Call of Duty videos when I was a little squeaker, and they were shit, but it just shows that I've always had the passion. But now I could actually attack this passion and go for it, because I'm not a squeaker anymore. I'm a bit older. I know how to edit videos a lot better, thumbnails and stuff like that, and just how to make videos. I understand it a lot more than I did back then, where I thought I could record some not HD gameplay and talk over it in a squeakiest voice and just make boring ass fucking videos once every like fucking 3 weeks. It's different now. So I feel like that's why I started YouTube now, knowing that I can actually make something of it, and I really enjoy it, and it's my passion. A passion is something that you want to do, and that's why I'm doing it. So yeah, thank you for the comment, man. That's my answer. Next question is from Absolute Genius, which is again another big comment. Congratulations, man. I don't have a clue why I'm so happy, even though you have done all the hard work and dedication to reach so far. I guess I'm just happy for you, mate, and I'm sure there is a long road ahead. And anytime you lack motivation, just read any of my comments, man. They are in almost every single video. You are correct, man. Your comments are in pretty much almost every single video, and I appreciate that so much. Thank you so much for the constant support, man. No question in that. I think he needs a question later on, so we'll get to that in a bit. But yeah, thank you so much, mate. I'm just trying to read if anything can hit. I'm just happy for you, mate. There's a long road ahead. Anytime you lack motivation, yeah. So thanks a lot, man. I really appreciate that comment, and I appreciate you as a subscriber and a fan, and just a legend. You're a legend, mate. So thank you so much, man. Appreciate it. I don't know how many times I'm going to say appreciate it, but I do. Words can't put into, I can't put it into words how much I appreciate your guys' support. So thank you. Thank you very much. Next question, which isn't a question again, from Mysterion Plays. Don't read this comment. Well, shit. Next question from Absolute Genius. Again, this is the question. Now I'm onto my question. Would you rather make videos for yourself and not give a shit about what your subscribers say, or do only videos for them and not give a shit about whether you enjoyed them? This is a tough question to answer, since right now you are still trying out different video genre apart from Rocket League. I think I make videos for myself and not give a shit about what your subscribers say. Not that I don't give a shit about you guys, but I wouldn't, if I'm not enjoying making videos, you guys are inevitably not going to enjoy them either, because I won't be happy in them and I won't be entertaining. If I'm making videos for myself only and I'm making fun videos, and you guys like don't really like it, if I'm enjoying it, then at least I'll find some people who do like it. And if even if I don't find anyone, if I'm enjoying it, that's all that matters for me. But I also, realistically, I want you guys to enjoy it just as much as I do, which is why most YouTubers try and find a middle ground, which is what I'm trying to do at the moment. But I think I've kind of sussed out the kind of way I'm going to take, which I'll talk about in another video, probably, where I'm going to take my YouTube channel. So, thank you very much, man, for the question. Next question from JT Gaming. Congrats, man, keep it up. Do you reckon you'd ever do Football Manager? Also, when's the next in real life football video coming? I will never do Football Manager, you fuck. And you know I won't. Maybe one day I might do like one Football Manager video, but I just don't think it'd be fun at all for you guys to watch. Also, when's the next in real life football video coming? Hopefully soon, guys. I really enjoyed that one. I want to do another one. I want to do one with my cousin as well. I think that'd be quite sick. And with all you guys, like JT Gaming and the Great GD, and that'd be awesome to make an in real football life video with you guys, and LS Media and shit like that. So definitely do one of those again soon. Colossus Gaming, who's a legend, by the way. Before my question, I just wanted to say, congratulations. You deserve this so much more than you realize. I am extremely grateful to have found your channel in the early stages that it is, instead of finding it when you have 100,000 subscribers, which I believe will occur. Thanks for giving 155 people a consistent, I would debate that, quality content that we know and love. Now, onto my question. List your top 5 favorite YouTubers. Once again, congrats. Thank you so much, man. I appreciate that. The fact that you said, which I believe will occur, to the 100,000 subscribers mark. Fuck me, man. You have faith, mate. You have faith. You have more faith than me. But hopefully one day we can smash it. And maybe one day we can reach that. That is like my ultimate goal is obviously like fucking have like millions and millions of subscribers, but my realistic goal, 100,000 subscribers, guys, if we could ever hit that ever, even if it takes years, that would be incredible, guys. So thank you so much for having faith in me, man. And thank you for the kind words. My top 5 favorite YouTubers. Fuck. Yeah, I'm gonna have to cut this video a bit and go make a little list, because I'm not really too sure who I pick. Right, guys, I've made a little list. It's gonna be at number 5. And this is not including any of my friends, like Dudes Plays, JT Gaming, The Great GD, and that, because I don't want them to be like, oh, you put me higher than you, or you put them. Regardless of my actual, like, mates, the people that I don't know who make YouTube videos that I love, and my top 5 would be at number 5, Ali A, at number 4, you know all of Ali A, at number 4, and, okay, no, I'll talk about them, so at number 5, we've got Ali A. He makes Call of Duty videos. I've been watching him for years. I mean, it's at least, like, a long fucking time, since he was Matrox on YouTube, then he changed his name. Yeah, I've been watching Ali A for ages. He's number 5. Number 4, Andy Worski. He makes like reaction videos, but it's really funny. They're not like fucking Jinx or CJ So-Cool reaction videos. He makes like proper long ones where he really talks about different videos, and his opinions are hilarious, and I think he's a legend. Number 3, The Joe Rogan Experience. I love this podcast. I listen to loads of them, and I'm trying to listen to every single one he puts out, but they're all like 3 hours long, so I listen to them while I'm at work or editing a video or something. I love The Joe Rogan Experience. And number 2, we have the Smith Plays, who's an amazing YouTuber, man. He's literally like one of my favorite YouTubers. He's inspirational as fuck. I don't really watch his zombies videos because they're really long and I'm not really into that at the moment, but his podcast and everything and his like normal videos I fucking love, and he's a massive inspiration for me. Number one, The Big Les Show, guys. I have just started watching The Big Les Show. I've watched all of it about twice now, and it is the funniest shit I've ever seen. If you haven't seen The Big Les Show, you have to go and watch it. I will just type in The Big Les Show and click on watch seasons 1 to 3. There's a video that literally says The Big Les Show seasons 1 to 3. Just watch all of it. The first couple of episodes aren't that good, but it gets so much better. And the last 50 minutes, the last hour, which is Tumor Island 2, the episode, is amazing. And they're bringing out a season 4 soon. I can't wait. That is a fucking incredible show. My fucking funniest thing I've ever seen in my life, hands down. Those are my top 5 YouTubers, guys. There's probably other ones I could fit in. It's like on honorable mentions, like Azora or Boogie2988 and things like that. But you know what? Those are my favorite top 5. Next question is from Future FIFA 350. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much do you hate Olivier Giroud? 1 being you really like him, 10 being you think he's terrible and don't like him. You know what, guys? He's not on form. He scored a hat-trick in Aston Villa game, but at the end of the season, he got on form, but a lot of the season, he wasn't really on form. It's not that I hate him, it's just that I think Arsenal deserves someone better up there, someone like Aubameyang. I'd love to see Aubameyang join Arsenal, for example. Olivier Giroud, he scored some bangers, don't get me wrong, and he has a fucking good shot on him, but he's not really interesting to watch at all. I'll give him like a 5. I don't really care. I just think we deserve someone better. Or maybe just he could just get better, but I don't really think. He's slow. He's not too interesting to watch. He's very good in the air, so corners are always interesting. But I think we deserve someone better, more interesting. So next question is from Lammy7. Congrats, bro. What are your ambitions for YouTube and the future? I pretty much answered this earlier. My ambitions for YouTube, my ultimate ambition is to turn this into a job and do this full time. It'd be amazing because I could do this. The thing that I love all the time, which is fucking incredible. For the future, just gonna stick at it, guys. Gonna stick at it, try and get better, try and become more consistent, and things like that, mate. That's pretty much it. Next question is from Hannah is not amazing. You're so humble and I just love that. Oh, thanks. I may as well just answer that bit first. Thank you so much. Being called humble is one of the biggest compliments I can think of. So the fact you see me as humble really does warm my fucking heart. So thank you so much for that, Hannah. But my question is, can you react to your most embarrassing moment video? I will, but not in this video because it'd be long. But I will definitely 100 million percent make a video where I react to that video. Hands down. Definitely. And congrats on 150 plus subscribers. Thank you so much, Hannah. You've been with me for fucking ages. You're a legend. Colossus Gaming. So many soccer questions on a gaming channel. Yeah, not soccer, mate. Football questions on a gaming channel. But yeah, because of the football YouTubers that came over. No, the FIFA YouTubers that came over from... other people who like FIFA that came over from Lammy7 and JT Gaming and that. But you know what? I love me a bit of football, lads. So I don't mind. The last question we have is from JT Gaming. Also, if you could sign 3 realistic players for Arsenal, who would they be? So not Messi, Neymar. So realistic, Aubameyang would be number one choice, I think. Benzema would be interesting, but he's getting kind of old and he wouldn't be with us for too long. But he's a fucking amazing. But I don't know, realistic Aubameyang. I'm trying to think of another 2. I don't know like that much about football where I can like really fucking scout the market and see who is our best bet. But I know Aubameyang, we've been linked with him a few times. I'd love to sign him. We've just signed some guy. I don't know who the fuck he is. We signed someone. Two people. I never know. I don't really know, mate. Aubameyang. I'm just going to say Aubameyang. I can't think of 3 people. We need... Who do we fucking need? Maybe a good midfielder. Fuck me. I don't know. I don't want to say anything stupid. So Aubameyang. I'll take him. Come here, Aubameyang. Come here, mate. Guys, that is the end of the questions. I am really tired from speaking so loud and so much. That's just the way it is, mate. But guys, I've answered all your questions and I love the questions you gave me. I think this is a really good video, hopefully. And thank you so much for your questions and thank you so much. We are on 158 subscribers at the moment, guys. I love you all and I'll catch you in the next video. Sorry for taking such a long break, guys, but yeah, catch you in the next video. Love you all. Peace.